Have you ever seen a Python script claiming to make your stick figure come alive, like in Alan Becker's Animator vs. Animation? Let's break down what this program really does. When you run the file called SymbolDirector.py, it looks impressive. It loads a fake configuration, types out mysterious logs, and says your stick figure's status is online. But nothing supernatural is happening. It's all simulation. Here's how it actually works. First, the program runs a function named main. That function loads a configuration file called symboldirector.json from your desktop. If it doesn't exist, it uses a set of built-in defaults. These defaults describe things like rigging, intelligence, and stats, such as power level or speed. They are just Python variables stored in memory. Next, the program pretends to awaken your stick figure. It creates a class object named symbol and runs a sequence of fake activation functions: apply effects, enable rigging, set stats, grant intelligence, enforce safety, and finally spark of life. Each function prints a series of log messages to the console, pauses for a fraction of a second, and continues. There is no animation engine, no connection to Adobe Animate, and no visual movement. All of the action you see is text printed with the Python logging module. The program ends by setting a variable alive equals true and displaying ready. Stickman can move freely. Cursor destruction remains disallowed. This line gives the illusion that the stick figure is conscious, but in reality, it's just a console message. So what is this program really? It's a clever parody that imitates the process of bringing a digital character to life, but purely through text simulation. It doesn't move any objects, draw any frames, or link to your animation software. It simply creates a storytelling illusion inside your terminal. The SymbolDirector script is harmless, safe to run, and great for fun or learning how structured Python code works. But if you want a stick figure that truly moves, you'll need to animate it manually or use a graphics library like Pygame or Manim. Thanks for watching.